Hi guys, welcome back to my channel. So today, we're doing a request for Tao Li from South Park. So let's talk about the colors that I used here. Obviously, white. Any four-weight white is fine. The purplish color that you see here is a Bernat Super Valium, and it's Wisteria is the color name. The yellow I did for the little booties is Loops and Threads Soft Classic Butter. The eyes are Loops and Threads Impeccable Heather. That's the color name. Then you're going to need some black. So just some scrap black and some scrap red for the end of his, I can't say that out loud. Let's jump right into this. The two hooks that I'm going to use with this project is a 3.5 millimeter E hook and a 4.5 millimeter G hook. So first things first, let's get this towel started. So I want you to start with your 4.5. The only thing that we're actually using the 3.5 for is going to be the eyes, the eyelids, and the cigarette. Everything else gets a 4.5. So we're going to start this towel with a chain 25. That's my chain 25. In this first stitch, I want you to put two single crochets in here. And then I want you to do 22 single crochets. So that's my 22nd stitch. I have one stitch left, and I'm going to put four single crochets in this last stitch, and I'm going to follow the curve. It's going to want to curve around to the left, and I'm going to follow it because I want to work on the other side of this chain. So make sure you pull your slip knot closed. Now working on the other side of the chain, I want you to do the exact same thing but backwards. So starting in this first stitch, next to the slip knot, we're going to do 22 single crochets. That leaves you with one stitch left at the other end. This is my 22nd stitch. I have one stitch left. I'm going to put two single crochets in there so I can match the other side because we started with two single crochets. So I'm just going to cut off my little straggler here. So that's the base of your towel. For the next five rows, you should have 52 stitches. For the next five rows, I just want you to put one single crochet in each of these 55 stitches. So you can use a marker so that you know what you're doing. So I am coming up on my end of my five rows, and I'm going to change to white on my last stitch. So that's my last stitch. I'm going to pull up a loop. I'm going to change to my white. You can change over however you want to change over. This is how I do it. And then with your white, you're going to do two rows and then go back to purple. So we don't increase or anything, it's just stays the same. So for the next two rows, you're going to be on white. So I'm on my last stitch of my two rows, and I'm going to go back to purple. And I'm going to do purple for the next two rows and go back to white. So I'm going to change to white on my last stitch, which is good because I just ran out of the little ball I had of my purple. So the plan is we're going to do two more rows of white and then go back to the purple, and then we'll end up doing 15 rows of the purple. So that's the plan. So two more rows of white, and then back to the purple. All right, I'm at the end of my two rows of white. I'm gonna go back to my purple. Now that we're back to purple, for the next 15 rows, I just want you to put one single crochet in each stitch. So I am coming to the end of my 15th row. And this is what you should have. So now we're going to change back to white. But as you can see where our location is, it's not a very location, good location. We want to at least be on the side with our other jogs. I want to line mine up over here. Then that's fine. You can do whatever stitches you need to do to line up your jog. So if I do 6, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, I'm going to be off my mark as well. So I think I'm going to move 3 and then change to my white. Now let's just see what it looks like. Okay, maybe change to my white on my fourth one. I think that's pretty good lined up. So I put 6 because of my original one. I guess I felt I needed to do 6. So, and again, you don't have to, but oh, it's going to look horrible if you don't. Alright, so we are going to be going back to purple. For the next two rows, I just want you to do one single crochet in each of these stitches with your white, and then we'll go back to purple. So we're just repeating what we did down here. So, I have got my two rows done. I'm going back to purple. Now, you don't have to cut these colors off every single time. It's completely up to you. You can kind of leave it hanging for when we come back. We're going to do two more rows of purple, and then we're going to go back to our white. So as long as it's not in your way, you don't need to cut it off every single time, but it doesn't really make a difference whether you do. So I'm coming to the end of my two rows for my purple. My white's already hanging here, so I'm going to go back to white. I'm just going to leave my purple hanging because I'm going to go back to purple. So two more rows of white, and then I'm going to go back to purple for six rows. So on my last stitch, gotta go back to purple, which is still just kinda hanging here. But I'm gonna be done with my white. So I'm gonna cut enough, I need some to tie a knot, but I'm gonna cut my white off. I'll still tie these. And then with my purple, I'm gonna do six rows. And then when we come back, we're going to change it up on the last row a bit. Well, not the last row, but we're going to do some weird stuff. So this is my sixth rows. That's what you should have. That's going to be your towel. So for our next round, here, get a needle here. We're going to be working into these back loops. And all I want you to do is one single crochet in each back loop. So that's all my back loops. So you should have all these exposed front loops. We're going to use those in a bit here. Just have that all the way around. For now, we're going to fasten off and we're going to whip stitch this closed. So we got to stuff it first. But lightly, it's just a towel. You don't want to be too much in there. And I just realized I'm not even on the side. I should have done a few more stitches to move over, so I'll have to take that out and do that. Yeah, so you see I'm not quite on the side. I gotta take my fasten off, back out, do a couple of stitches, put it back in. One of those days, you know? There we go, and I'm gonna pass it off here. That makes more sense to me. So, I think I'm good as far as how much I have stuffed. So we can get this whip stitch closed. And then we continue to build off of this. So we're going to reattach in the exposed front loops from round 40. So these fellas. So let's reattach into there with our same color purple. So the very last loop on the front, make sure you have 26 loops across. Six, 26 should take you right to the other side. So that's perfect for me. I'm going to reattach. I want you to do 26 single crochets. I'm going to start my first stitch in the spot that I just reattached in because all I put was a single crochet. Or a slip stitch, sorry, that's what I meant. So 26 stitches takes you all the way over to the other side. So this is my 26th stitch. This is what you should have. That's your top where we whip stitched it. So this is what you should have here. Just like that. I want you to turn your work. Chain one right here. And I want you to do 26 single crochets, but this time I want you to go through your front loop on the other side and then into your stitch. Oops, wrong stitch. So through your front loop into your stitch. I'll show you that again because I almost dropped it. So these are your exposed front loops from the row, but at the back, because we use the ones at the front, and then into your, sorry, I know, I keep moving it, into your stitches up here. It's hard for me to see what I'm doing, that's why I keep moving it. I'll try again. I'm trying to do this blind. It's hard to see. So into your stitches up here. And then single crochet. So you're doing 26 all the way across. When you come to this end, you're going to notice your jog drops down to here. From up here, it'll drop down here. So just make sure you can still get into it. This might pull your piece up a little bit higher, but it won't be that noticeable. So this is my last loop. It's a little difficult. And my last stitch. Anyway, I think that aesthetically looks better. So for the next 7 rows, you're just going to do 1 single crochet, chain 1, turn, chain 1, turn. I'm going to weave in my straggler from the beginning. Just remember, you have 26 stitches across. So this is the end of my 7 rows. I'm going to chain 1, turn my work. And now I want to decrease. So I want to decrease these 2 stitches. Then I want to do 22 single crochets across. And then decrease these last 2 stitches. So that's my 22, and I'm going to decrease these last 2 stitches. Chain 1, turn your work. So your very last row, that's all we're decreasing, just to bring it in a little bit. So your very last row is going to be 1 single crochet in each of these 24 stitches. So you can fasten off, whoops, you just need enough to weave in. So depending on which is, this is going to be my back because my dogs are right there, but you can't see them from the side, so this will be my front, which is where we started doing our 26 across anyway. So this is technically supposed to be kind of always flipped back like that, which is why I did what I did on the top. Every picture I saw of Tao Li had this. Now, I don't watch the show, I'm too old, but he's got this flip over for the towel part, so. You can block it if you want, but I didn't bother because it's just a towel, so I didn't really care how it laid one side curled up or not. So now that that is done, we can get right to our arms and our legs. So let's start with yellow. We're going to start with the boot for the leg. We're using a 4.5 still, and I want you to chain 9. I want you to start doing 4 single crochets. That's my 4 single crochets. And now I want you to do 2 half doubles. And I want you to do a double crochet. And in this last stitch, I want you to do 6 double crochets. So follow the curve around so that you're coming around this way. We're going to work on the other side of this chain for our boot. And we're going to do exactly what we did on the other side. We're just going to do it backwards. So we're going to start with one double crochet, two half doubles, and four singles. So I was weaving my little straggler there at the back, but if you didn't, you can just sew it right in. No big deal. I'm going to cut the straggler off. You don't have to, it's just, it's annoying, so I do. So I'm going to start using a stitch marker just so it's easier to follow along. This first stitch is going to get two single crochets in them. So how it's written with brackets around it for my channel generally means the same space or a special sequence. In this instance, it means the same space. So put your second stitch into that same stitch. Now I want you to do four single crochets up. Now three half doubles. In these next four stitches, I want you to do two double crochets in each of them. So now starting down the other side, you're going to do three half doubles. Four single crochets. And two single crochets into your last stitch. So that should match the other side perfectly. So flip this around. And your next round is just going to be one single crochet in what should be 26 stitches. So that is my 26 stitches. Your next round starts with 9 single crochets, and then we're going to decrease around the toe area. So that's my 9 single crochets, and now we're going to do one single crochet decrease 3 times. So that's one single crochet, and then your decrease 1 time. One single crochet and a decrease 2 times. And the last time. And then 8 single crochets back to your marker. This will leave you with 23 stitches. So your next round starts with 8 single crochets. That's 8 single crochets, and then we do the same thing. One single crochet and a decrease 3 times. and then 6 single crochets back to your marker. So this leaves you with 20 stitches. Your next round starts with 7 single crochets. That's my 7. And then you're going to do the same thing. 1 single crochet decrease 3 times. And then 4 single crochets to the end, leaving you with 17 stitches. So, the last row before we switch to our white, I want you to start with 6 single crochets. That's my 6 single crochets. The same thing, 1 single crochet decrease 3 times. And then 2 single crochets to the end, leaving you with 14 stitches. So on this last stitch, we got to switch to white. But this is what you should have. I'm going to put some stuffing in mine before I make my color change and everything. Alright, so I got to back out of this last stitch. I got to change to white. So with your white, we're going to be using our back loops only. So these guys right here. And you're going to do a 5 single crochet decrease all the way around. In the back loops only. So now you should have 12 stitches. For the next 10 rows, you're just going to put 1 single crochet in each of these 12 stitches. Stuff as you go, and I will see you on the other side. Alright, that is my 10 rows. So you can fasten off. Make sure you're on the side because we're going to whip stitch this closed. You need a sewing tail. So this is what you should have. I want to reattach using these front loops down here, but I think I think I'll let you build the second leg before we do that. I'm just gonna go in and make a knot. So yeah, go in and build your second leg and put the pattern up, and then I'll meet you back, and then we'll touch on these front loops. So, I am back with my second leg. This is what we're going to do with these front loops. So, this is called a twisted single crochet. And that's going to make it look like a boot. So, that's what we're going to do. If you choose. Now, if you don't want to, then you can leave it just like this. It's your choice. So make a slip knot. Come over here and find where you jog. So up here and then down here, that'll be your jog. Start in a small one or in the lower one. You can reattach any way you want. I'm just going to do a slip stitch. And I'm going to want you to pull up on here and make a decent sized loop. Go back into that same stitch. Start your first stitch. Pull up on the loop. So both loops need to pull up on. Then you're going to twist it. Yarn over and pull through. The important thing is you pulling up on both the loops. And now you got to pull up on this loop. Go into your next stitch. Pull up on that loop. Then you can twist it. Yarn over and pull through. The higher you pull up, the bigger your boot cuff is going to be. But it's going to be super easier to do this stitch if you pull up on both loops. So your last stitch is going to be up higher because that's, again, the jog. So you're going to be sitting up higher. So I want you to come in here and go into the first stitch that you put your slip stitch into to fasten off. Just need tying, a little bit of a tying tail. So when you do that, you can't really tell there's that big of a jog. Now, I do like to tie these two together before I weave them away. Very small knots, so super duper tightly small knots, just so nobody knows they're there. So, now that you're done your boot cuff, we can sew these on. So that's about how I want them to be. There should be a gap in between. I'm just going to use a mattress stitch and go all the way around. But you can sew these on any way that you like. So I'm in the row just above where we started. And then when I do the other side of the leg, I'll be in the row below the row that I started crocheting in the first place. So the easiest part about mattress stitch is you don't have to pull right away. You can kind of get all your loops in order. Making sure you stay in the same line. So that's my first, well, that's my front. And then we pull. So now when I do the back, this is the first chain that we made when we started this project. So I did the row in front, and now I'm going to do the row. Sorry, this is the first chain, so I'm going to do, sorry, this is the first chain that we started with, so I'm going to do the row behind it for my mattress stitch. So I've met up in the same hole to do first a light knot, then a tight knot, and weave it away. So my legs are definitely not in the middle, but they're close, but they're not quite. But it does not surprise me as far as my sewing. So let's start by making our thumbs and fingers first, so we can make the hands and then into the arms. So first let's make the thumb. You're going to do a magic ring of 5 single crochets. For the next 4 rows, you're just going to put 1 single crochet in each of these 5 stitches. So if you don't need your stitch marker, you can just count to 20. So after my first row, I like to tie a knot at the back just so my magic ring on my finger doesn't continue to open. So I tie a double knot. You can either weave this in or just tie a knot. And I'm going to be doing this for all my fingers as well, just because you don't want this to open. So that's my 4 rows, so this is what you should have. So you can go ahead, fasten off, and make thumb number 2. So now that our thumbs are done, we can start building the fingers. So we make 3 all together, but we don't fasten off the very last finger because that's how we start our hand, is still being attached. So I'm going to do one with you and then leave you to do the other 2, and I'll be sure to write just below the pattern, do not fasten off the last finger, just so you can remember. So this starts with a magic ring of 5 single crochets, just like the thumb. This one is going to get 5 rows instead of 4, so one more extra row than the thumb. So 5 rows, so you can just count to 25. And again, after every first row on all my fingers, I'm going to be tying my knots. So that's my 25 stitches. So you can go ahead and fasten off. Make 3 fingers for each hand. But we have to do one hand at a time because you can't fasten off your last finger. So make as many as you want. Just know that 2 of those are going to need to be stayed attached to. So go ahead and make your fingers. Stay attached to the last finger of one of the hands, and I'll meet right back here. So, using 2 fingers, first I'm going to put my stitch marker in here, just so I know where my first stitch is going to be. Using 2 stitches, I want you to sew your fingers together. So I generally start, I didn't stuff any of mine by the way. I generally start right next to where my first stitch is going to be for sewing. So that's 2 stitches and I'm going to make a knot. So your first round after sewing all your fingers together is going to be 1 single crochet in each stitch. And I want you to get 15 stitches. So you probably have to use your sew spots. Well, that's 15 stitches for me, using all my sew spots. So that kind of spread your fingers out a little bit better. And now we're going to sew the thumb on, using 2 stitches, just like the fingers. So just fold this finger in half. You can see the 2 stitches right there. One more time through the last stitch to make a knot. So now you have your thumb sewn on. So now I want you to do 1 single crochet around, 1 single crochet in each stitch. Now I want you to get 20 stitches. And again, that'll just be a matter of using these sew spots as well. This is my 20th stitch. I'm going to decrease a little bit. I'm going to do 1 single crochet and a decrease, but I'm only going to do it 6 times. So that's 1 single crochet and then a decrease. That's 1 time. Thank you. So this is my sixth time. And then I want you to do two single crochets. This should leave you with 14 stitches. So we continue to decrease. I want you to do a 5 single crochet decrease. This will bring you down to 12. Your next round is going to be 4 single crochets and a decrease. This brings you down to 10 stitches. So you should have 10 stitches. For the next 15 rows, I just want you to put one single crochet in each of these 10 stitches. Now before we start, I gotta tell you, I don't stuff my fingers. The only thing I stuff is the little hand part. And that's with very, 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 very light stuffing. So, I also lightly stuffed my arms just so that they were a little more bendable and pliable. So you're going to have to stuff as you go, but I would just lightly stuff it. And I will see you after your 15 rows is done. So this is my 15 rows. The top of it, I still have to stuff it, but the top of it gets whip stitched and then sewn to the side of the arm. So make sure you're fastening off on the side. I'm going to finish stuffing mine, whip stitch it. All the while, I'm going to put the pattern on the screen and I'm going to back out one stitch to end my fasten off, just do my fasten off. So you just need a sewing tail. So I'm going to put the pattern on the screen and you can go ahead and make your second arm and I'll meet you right back here. So they get sewn on with the thumb pointing out into the white, either white part, doesn't matter. My last one, I made my arms smaller, so they kind of just came out the sides here. But his arms seemed too small, so I made them a little bigger for this guy. So I'm just going to do... I'm just going to do a mattress stitch and I'm going to use my first white row because this arm's going to kind of get bent around to the front where I'm going to sew in my cigarette and yeah, that's the plan. So these are my where my dogs are. So you're not gonna really see much of the dog either. So, let's get this eyeball done. So I'm using this taupe color, or whatever it's called. We talked about at the beginning anyway, I don't remember. And I'm using a 3.5 millimeter e-hook. And I want you to start off by chaining 7. I want your first stitch to have 2 single crochets, but after your first one, that's where I want you to put a marker. Then your second stitch can go in that same space. Your next 3 stitches are going to be half doubles. So 3 half doubles. Your next stitch is going to have 2 half doubles in it. And then your very last stitch is going to get 4 single crochets. So we're going to follow the direction that this goes around. And then we're going to work on the other side of this chain. So, pull your slip knot nice and tight. We're going to weave in this tail to keep that closed. And in your first stitch, I want you to put 2 half doubles. Now I want you to do 3 half doubles down. And then in your last stitch, I want you to put 2 single crochets. So that's what you should have. I'm going to cut this off the back since I weaved it in. One more row. So this should look like a rib cage. If you can see what I'm talking about. You're going to start off with your first stitch getting 2 single crochets. And again, the marker goes on to the first stitch. So 2 single crochets into the first stitch. Your second stitch is going to get 2 single crochets. And then I want you to do 5 half doubles up. So we're right at the top. You've got 4 stitches at the top around this curve. You're going to put 2 single crochets in each of these 4 stitches. And then I want you to do 5 half doubles down. So you should have these 2 stitches left, and you're going to put 2 single crochets in each of them. So just like we did when we started. That is it. That's what you should have. You can fasten off. with sewing tail. So I'm going to put the pattern up, and I want you to go ahead and make your second eye, and then meet me right back here. So my eyes are pinned in place, and they're going to get sewn together like these guys, sewn in the middle together. So we'll do that first, and then we'll make what we need for the rest of it. So the pupil is done with the 3.5, and it is just a magic ring of 6 single crochets. So you can pop over into your first stitch. Fasten off. The sewing tail. So to keep your pupil closed, you can tie a knot back here with your straggler, or you can sew it in. So we have eyebrows we're going to need to do first before we figure out where our pupils are going. But for now, I'll just pin that there. So I'll make number two. So let's do the eyelids. We need the same color purple. There are some pictures out there that show with a different color purple, but I'm just going to use the same color as I was using before. So we're making this with the same hook, the 3.5. And I want you to chain 7. And do 6 single crochets back up. Chain 1, turn your work. In this first stitch, you're going to put 2 single crochets. Then you're going to do 4 single crochets across. And in your last stitch, you're going to put 2 single crochets. chain one, turn your work. So now I just want you to put one single crochet in each stitch, and that'll be the end of this eyebrow or eyelid. So you'll need a sewing tail, and then this does cover the brown part. So make eyelid number two, and then we can get sewing those on. So, first things first, we have to sew our eyeballs on. I don't sew here. I just sew around here. That's it. So, not last but not least, we need to grab our black again. Let's just make some eyebrows and a mouth. So we'll go out here, it doesn't matter where you command, just where you pop out. Leave some hanging. So I'm going to go in here and then I'm going to pop out about midway through that hole there. And then I'm going to pull this, see him on this side? I'm going to pull this back and I'm going to go down the same hole, but on the other side. And that will help me shape the eyebrow. Go down the other side. I have to walk down here to make my way down here. And we're just gonna do a little mouth. And then I'm going to meet up with where I started. tie my knots. So the very last thing we have to do is his smoke. So red and white, that's all you're gonna need next. So let's start with red and your 3.5, and you're gonna make a magic ring of 5 single crochets. Your first round is going to be 2 single crochets in each stitch, bringing you up to 10 stitches. That's my 10. Pull my middle closed. I'm going to do 1 single crochet in each of these 10 stitches, and then I'm going to switch to white. So I'm going to weave my tail in here. So this is my last stitch. I'm going to flip this around before I do my change though. So that's my last stitch. I'm going to go to white. This white is thicker than my red, which is what we want because we just want a little burner on the end of this. I'm not going to switch hooks though. So with your white, you're going to do 2 rounds, 1 single crochet in each of these 10 stitches, and then we're going to start to decrease. All right, I'm just gonna tuck everything in. What I've just tucked in is about the only stuffing you're gonna use. So your next round is gonna be 3 single crochets in a decrease. This will bring you down to 8 stitches. So for the next 2 rows, you're just going to put 1 single crochet in each of these 8 stitches. So I'm just going to count to 16. Alrighty, we're going to decrease again. You're going to do 2 single crochets in a decrease. This brings you down to 6 stitches. So for the next 2 rows, you're going to put 1 single crochet in each of these 6 stitches, and that will be it. So I'm just going to count 12. That's my 12th stitch, so I'm going to go in, fasten off. Need a little bit of a sewing tail. And a cinching tail. So if you want to put stuffing in this, that's perfectly fine. You can go right ahead. I am not going to. So you're going to go in the front loop of the first stitch and out the front loop of the second stitch to do your cinch. Pull that closed and then pop across and make your knots. There we go. You can choose a hand. Whatever hand you choose, you can sew it into place. So I'm going to go all the way down through, not this finger, although I have some of it snagged, down through the cigarette, into the finger, into the body to start. That's what I'm doing so far. In case you're wondering what the heck. So now that I got it kind of in place, I'm going to go back up the same hole I came out. Go into a different part of the finger. So I don't want to go back up the same side. And then I'm going to come and go through this last finger here. I'm sure you can sew it on any way you want to. And that's kind of how I did it. Then I come up the finger, weaving. But I'm pretty anal with wanting to make knots to secure it, so I just grab a little piece, make a knot where it's not going to be that noticeable, push it down as far as I can, and then continue to weave. So that's what I did. And like I said, you can do whatever you want with this other hand. You don't have to do anything with your other hand. But that is it. We are done.